Hey, what's up guys? I'm Luki Pookie, and today I'm excited to talk about the changes Valve finally made to the Pretty Boy's pocket pistol. The pocket pistol is now pretty good, and at that maybe too good as some are saying, so let's take a look at its new stats and talk about it. The stats themselves are old news, since Valve made no changes to what they proposed a few months ago. But just to refresh you, here they are. Up to plus 7 HP per hit from the previous plus 5, plus 15% firing speed from the prior minus 25% penalty, and minus 25% clip size, meaning 9 shots per clip. First important thing to note is they removed the 20% damage vulnerability on wearer stat. You're no longer a dead man when you use this weapon. They also removed the fall damage resistance. The firing speed buff is also big news since it's now 40% faster than before. That means you fire a bullet every 0.1445 seconds. The stock, in comparison, fires every 0.17 seconds. That might not sound like a huge difference on paper, but as you can see, it does make quite a noticeable difference in-game.
What, you didn't see it?
Yeah, I'm kidding, it's really tiny. You fire 9 shots 1/5 of a second faster. It's barely comprehensible without a side-by-side comparison right in front of you. The clip size penalty, to my surprise, is also very mild. You can miss out on 24 to 66 damage per clip compared to the pistol, and though that can bite you sometimes, the positives do make up for it quite significantly. And that brings us to the last stat, plus 7 HP per hit. If you were to hit a guy with all 9 of your shots, you'd get 63 health in 1.3 seconds. That is equivalent to a medium health kit, but that's if you land all your shots. With the pistol's wonky accuracy, that's not guaranteed of course, but the health you get can be impactful regardless. The pocket pistol works wonders in 1v1 fights where you find yourself with an empty clip in your primary and you've been wounded. The faster firing speed and the health you're granted help out a lot, and the clip size penalty is negligible if your enemy's already on low health from your scattergun shots. In fact, some people are saying the pocket pistol does too much given the lackluster penalty. The weapon is not absurdly overpowered or game-breaking, but it's up to debate whether it's a straight upgrade to the stock pistol. After seeing how tiny of a difference plus 15% firing rate is compared to the stock, I think it's barely worth noting as it is. They could probably take it away in-game secretly without stating it, and 10% of people would notice. I'm personally not under the impression the weapon is super overpowered, but if you were to change anything to tune it down slightly, I'd suggest one of two different routes. One is they could slow the firing speed to be something like minus 15% to make it inferior to the stock slightly in another regard. That would make the thing fire 9 shots 1/5 of a second slower than the stock rather than faster. This is probably the best of my two ideas. The second route they could take, which I'm not as keen to, is shrinking the clip size further to maybe 6 to 8 shots. I don't like this idea as much, since it's running the risk of introducing the same problem the old Winger had. The small clip size mixed with the pistol's shit accuracy makes for a bad day, as we learned through the old iteration of the Winger, back when it had a damage bonus, a smaller clip size, and nothing else to redeem it. Where the weapon stands now, a competitive ban might happen, especially in sixes, but if it goes unbanned, it may very well become the new meta. Either way, I find it unlikely that Valve will implement a nerf soon, and I cross my fingers they aren't going to mega nerf it into oblivion, making it dog trash again. There is the argument that the pocket pistol is lurking too far into the territory of the Mad Milk, but that's not really a concern to me personally. In general, I'm happy with the direction Valve have taken with the pocket pistol, and it's nice to see a buff amidst the scout nerfs. Everything considered, I think it might be smart to let the pocket pistol settle in for a short period of time before deciding what changes, if any, are necessary. If we give it a little while longer in the comp scene, we might just see people switching back to the pistol out of preference after all, and then bam, it doesn't need to be nerfed. But that is optimistic thinking, so you may want to brace for some more rebalancing just in case. I didn't mean to make that rhyme and make it cheesy as hell. But that being said, hope you guys have an awesome rest of your day or night, and peace out.